When packing a soil cooler, the most important thing is to not overload the cooler. Try to limit the total weight to less than 40 pounds. Anything over 40 pounds is considered unsafe. It's a safety risk for the person taking the samples, the courier transporting the cooler, and for the staff receiving samples. In this case, we have a half-full box of jars. We recommend that you reuse the boxes that the jars were supplied to you in. The cardboard cutout pieces provide a buffer between individual containers so they don't hit each other during transport and cause a potential break. One consideration when using the boxes is to make sure there is no additional moisture at the bottom. If they do get wet, the boxes can fall apart as the structural integrity degrades. The easiest way to pack a cooler is to take your box of jars and place it in the cooler. Likewise for methanol vials, again shipping back to us in the box provided to you is the best way to go. The cardboard dividers prevent the vials from breaking when transported, and it ensures that the vials are upright during transport, which is important to prevent the vials from leaking. One important thing to note is that if you are testing for methanol, you should ship those samples in a cooler that does not contain methanol vials. Another thing to keep in mind is that if you are shipping methanol vials, you don't exceed any dangerous goods regulations. Place the jars on the bottom and the box of vials on top. You can now fill the void space with soil bags. The soil bags can act as a buffer for the boxes so they don't shift while in transport as you drop them off or courier the samples to us. You can add ice packs if you like to make sure the samples are not overheated. Hydrocarbon samples should be maintained at 4 degrees Celsius. Don't forget to include a chain of custody form. It's best to put the chain of custody form in a Ziploc bag to ensure that it is not damaged by moisture from the cooler.